Hey everyone, it's Carrie. Welcome to my new channel, Carrie's Thrifty Farmhouse. If you like decorating on a budget, you're in the right place. I'd like to start out by thanking all my existing subscribers, and if this is your first time stopping by, be sure to drop me a comment below so we can connect. For today's project, I'm making four different cone-style Christmas trees, all from Dollar Tree products. If you enjoy this video, I would love for you to like, comment, and hopefully subscribe so I can grow my channel. So with all the formalities out of the way, let's get started. We'll start out by creating the cone shape. I feel like I'm back in my high school geometry class with my simple compass. I just attached a string to a pencil. Then I'm holding the end of the string at the corner of the poster board, and with the other hand drawing a line with the pencil. It's essentially creating a quarter of a circle. Then you simply bend the poster board into the cone shape and tape it down. For their larger cones today, I'm creating a cone that is approximately 3/4 of the width of the poster board, and the smaller cones are approximately 1/2 the width. For my first Christmas tree today, I'm using the poster board, tacky glue, and two of these soft white fleece cloths. I found them in the hardware/automotive section at Dollar Tree. I start out by cutting the fleece in half lengthwise and then half again. Then I layer two of the strips on top of each other and begin cutting triangles. Lots and lots of triangles. Repeat this for the second pair of strips and then repeat these steps with the second cloth as well. Now it's time to attach the triangles to the cone. Start at the bottom and attach the triangles with the points facing the bottom of the cone. You'll want to overlap them a bit so that none of the poster board shows through. In this first row, the triangles will hang over the edge. That's okay. We'll be tucking the fabric underneath later in the project. In the second row, similar to a brick pattern, you'll want to place the triangles in between the pieces in the row below, so that the points hang down in between the points below. When necessary, just overlap the triangle slightly to achieve the desired look. Continue with this pattern all the way up to the top of the cone. When you get to the very top of the cone, look at the tree and decide which part you want to be the front of the tree. Turn it around and place the second to last piece on the back side so that the last piece is on the front. Now it's time to fold the points underneath and glue them down. Trim any points from the second row that are hanging below the bottom since they aren't long enough to fold underneath and glue. I apologize for the lighting in this clip. I paused to make dinner for the family and when I returned, I didn't realize I had lost so much light. And here's the final product. I just love how this turned out. And since it's not particularly Christmassy, I see this working well, not just for the holidays, but for all winter. In this next project, I used poster board, two decks of cards, and twine. I also used four different colors of paint, white, charcoal, silver, and gold. I'll provide a list of all the brands and specific colors in the description box below. I started out by creating a flower petal template out of a scrap piece of poster board. Then I used it to cut out petals from the playing cards. I cut out both decks of cards, but I probably only used about 80 of them. The amount you will need, of course, depends on the size of the cone. Now I'm painting the pieces with white chalk paint. I'm using a version by Deco Art available on Amazon, but you can use anything you have on hand. I do recommend using chalk paint for this base coat since it's a little thicker than regular acrylic paint and adheres to virtually anything, which is great for this project since cards are a little slick. Now I'm using a dry brush and lightly brushing on a silver paint. I love Martha Stewart's metallic silver paint. I use this paint in all sorts of projects, but I've had the paint for over 5 years and barely used half the container. I'm brushing on different amounts on each piece, so each one looks a little different. I love how the dry brush leaves a few streaks. I'm going for the look of a birch tree in this project, so the streaks look a little like bark. For this next step, I'm using a piece that I cut off of a mesh scouring sponge. Because of the mesh, it gives the paint almost a splatter effect. It's fun to test out different tools to see how it changes the look of the paint. I'm adding metallic gold paint sparingly on the pieces. I'm using Folk Art Antique Gold here. Again, some pieces get more, some less, so that there's variation. Now I'm using my other favorite paint, the color Elephant by Waverly Chalk Paint, available at Walmart. I'm again using the mesh scouring sponge, but this time I have a heavier hand, again, blotting each piece differently. This is meant to look like the black areas seen on birch trees. I ended up adding some burlap ribbon at the bottom of the tree. This gives the bottom a more finished look, but the petals just barely turn up at the end, so you could probably get away without doing this. And here I'm trying to show the final petals. The metallic paint gives it that streaky bark look, but it really glistens when it catches the light. I may have to add fairy lights to the completed project. And now it's time to attach the petals. In this project, I'm using the hot glue gun. I wasn't sure if they would stick because of the card's slick surface, but it worked surprisingly well. If I planned to sell or give this tree away, I might have added some E6000 to give a more permanent hold, but the glue gun worked fine in this case. Similar to the fleece tree, I'm offsetting the petals so that each petal hangs down in the middle of the two below it. I didn't want to lay the tree flat and test the hold of the hot glue, so I apologize if this angle wasn't the best, but just continue this pattern up the tree. It did get a little tricky at the top because the pieces didn't want to bend around the tree. I solved this problem by cutting down some of the petals and ended up wrapping the very top in twine. And here's the final tree. I always say this, but I just love how it turned out. You may notice that I decided to paint the twine top white. I think it blends much better with the rest of the tree. And it's hard to catch on camera, but the petals really shine when they catch the light. It's just beautiful. And now on to our third tree. For this project, you'll need the poster board, green floral moss, twine, and a berry floral pick. At Dollar Tree, they have a lighter and a darker berry pick, and I like the darker red one for this project. I'm starting out by painting the tree green. There doesn't need to be perfect coverage since I'll be covering the tree with moss anyway. The paint I'm using is a chalk paint by the Waverly brand from Walmart, and the color is fittingly called moss. Next, I'm using the glue gun to apply bunches of moss around the tree. There's not really any art to this part, but I did find it easier to cover a whole side and then work around the tree as opposed to working bottom to top like the other trees we did earlier. Now I'm using scissors to give him a little bit of a haircut and trimming off any places where there is excess moss. Then I'm going to go back and fill in any bare spots where the cone shows through. Next, I'm giving the tree some twine garland. I'm just wrapping up the tree and then down so that it creates some spots where the twine overlaps. Then I just glue the ends of the twine to the inside of the cone. Now it's time to add the berries. When I pulled them off the floral pick, some came off in small bunches, which I actually liked. However, one negative is that the berries are made out of styrofoam, so there are some white spots where they pull off the stem. I was just strategic with the gluing and made sure to glue the white side down so hardly any white shows in the end. And here he is. Isn't he handsome? Don't tell the others, but this may be my favorite of the four trees because he really fits that traditional farmhouse aesthetic that I love. Okay, we made it to the last of the four trees. For this project, all I used was the cone and this buffalo plaid hat. Buffalo plaid is really popular now, so I knew I had to incorporate it somehow, and this is definitely the easiest of the four trees. I started out by removing the ball and the fur trim and then cutting along one of the side seams. The nice thing is that the fabric is already in a cone shape. The fur sheds a lot, so we needed a little cleanup. I couldn't find our lint roller, so I ended up having to vacuum it off. Just keeping it real around here. There's really not much to this project. Just lay the cone down and glue the fabric around it. The only thing to keep track of is the existing seam in the fabric, which was the side seam of the hat. I wanted that to be toward the side of the tree as well, even though it's technically the middle of the fabric. So I was just strategic with my gluing, and it worked out fine because the tree is smaller than the hat was. Tuck and glue at the top, making sure that you fold toward the back so that the front has a finished look. At the back, I also folded over the unfinished fabric before gluing it down so that it looked like another finished seam. Now I'm adding the fur trim back on. You could also add the ball back on if you like. Make sure the seam is on the back side of the tree. I also gave them a quick comb to make sure there weren't any more loose strands. And here is the final product. Really simple to do and fits great into current trends. You could even turn him into a gnome, which is another big trend recently. So there you have it, 4 beautiful trees, each of which could fit into different styles of decor. I already have ideas for where they will fit into the different rooms in our house. I hope this video inspired you to get crafty and achieve the look for less. I think I figured out that the total cost for all 4 trees was $11 plus paints I already had on hand. What a steal. If you liked this video, please consider subscribing and hitting the notification button so you will be notified when I upload future videos. I have lots of holiday projects already in the works that I know you will love, so keep your eye out for those. See you next time. Bye!